Assalamualaikum and good day to Dr. Wan and my fellow friend. Thank you for joining me today. My name is Muhammad Iqbal and I'm excited to talk to you about hydrogen as future energy. This presentation will cover various aspects of hydrogen, including its production, application and potential to be a key energy source of the future. Let's start with an overview of the global energy landscape. As we know, the global energy demand is continuously increasing due to population growth and industrial development. Our current reliance on fossil fuels such as coal, oil, and natural gas contributes significantly to environmental pollution and climate change. It's clear that we need to find more sustainable and cleaner energy sources to meet our growing energy needs. Let's move to the importance of finding sustainable and clean energy sources. There is pressing a need to transition to sustainable energy sources to reduce greenhouse gas emission and combat climate change. And renewable energy sources like wind, solar and hydro are gaining traction, but they have limitations related to their intermittency and energy storage. What is hydrogen? Hydrogen is the most abundant element in the universe. It is colorless, odorless and highly flammable gases. Hydrogen constitutes about 75% of the elemental mass of the universe. It is found in star and gas giant planets. Role hydrogen in energy sector. Hydrogen can be used as energy carrier and fuel. When used in fuel cell, it produces electricity with water as the only byproduct. And lastly, hydrogen can be stored and transported efficiently, making it a versatile energy storage, energy sources. Now let's dive into how hydrogen is produced. There are several methods to produce hydrogen, each with its own advantages and challenges. First, we have electrolysis, which involves splitting water into hydrogen and oxygen using electricity. If this electricity comes from renewable sources like wind or solar power, the hydrogen produced is termed as green hydrogen. This method is environmentally friendly as it produces no carbon dioxide emission. Next, we have steam methane reforming, or SMR. SMR converts methane and water into hydrogen and carbon monoxide through a chemical reaction. This reaction typically takes place at high temperature in presence of a catalyst. The carbon monoxide can further react with water to produce additional hydrogen and carbon dioxide. Lastly is photocatalysis. Photocatalysis uses sunlight to split water into hydrogen and oxygen. This process involves a photocatalyst, a material that absorbs sunlight and drives the water splitting reaction. Photocatalysis is an emerging technology with the potential for high efficiency and sustainability, offering a promising method for a green hydrogen production. Now, let's move to the application of hydrogen. Hydrogen has a wide range of applications across in various sectors. In transportation, hydrogen fuel cell combine hydrogen and oxygen to produce electricity, emitting only water and heat. For example, hydrogen power cars like Toyota Mirai and Hyundai Nexo, hydrogen buses operating in cities worldwide, and hydrogen power truck and train. For us, the benefit is zero emission, high energy efficiency, and quick refueling times compared to battery electric vehicles. Next is industry in steel manufacturing. Hydrogen can replace a coal product. In reducing iron ore to produce steel, significantly cutting carbon dioxide emission in the steel making process. Lastly is energy storage, which is power to gas technology. In the process, excess renewable energy from wind or solar is used to produce hydrogen via electrolysis. For the storage, hydrogen can be stored in the tank or underground cavern, so the stored hydrogen can be converted back to electricity when needed or used as a fuel. The benefit of this is it balances the supply and demand of renewable energy, provides a long-term storage solution and support grid stability. Looking ahead, hydrogen has the potential to revolutionize our energy system. What is the potential to be used as future energy? First is decarbonization of hard to electrified sector. For the heavy industry, hydrogen can replace fossil fuels in steel and cement production, reducing carbon dioxide emission. And second is for the transportation. Power-heavy vehicles such as buses, trains and ships offering a clean alternative to diesel and gasoline. Second is versatility as an energy carrier. Multiple production method, hydrogen can be produced from water, which is electrolysis, to a natural gas, SMR, and biomass. For the storage and transport, easily stored and transported, making it a flexible energy carrier. Next is environmental benefit. First, zero emission. Hydrogen use produce only water vapor, ensuring zero carbon emission at the point of use. Next is the greenhouse gas reduction. Green hydrogen produced from renewable energy significantly cuts greenhouse gas emission. And lastly is for the economic opportunity. For first is job creation. Hydrogen economy development creates jobs in manufacturing, installation, maintenance, and R&D. Second is technological innovation. Investment in hydrogen spurs advancement in fuel cell, electrolyzer and storage solution. And lastly is a global leadership. Investing in hydrogen technologies position country as a leader in a global hydrogen market. As a conclusion, hydrogen is a versatile clean energy carrier that can significantly reduce greenhouse gas emission and decarbonize various sectors including transportation and industry. It enhances energy security by enabling local production and diversified energy sources, supported by government strategy and technological advancement. Hydrogen is crucial for achieving a sustainable energy future. Continued investment and international collaboration are essential to fully realize hydrogen potential, driving economic growth and paving the way for a cleaner and more sustainable future. I think that's all from me. Thank you for your attention.